Good evening. Welcome to Christmas Eve worship here at Piedmont Community Church. We're glad that all of you are here today. We realize that we have some guests here tonight, maybe for the first time in a long time, or maybe your first time ever. We want to extend a really special welcome to you. We're glad you're here with us. If you would like some information about our church, you could fill out one of these Connect cards. They're in the back of the pew right in front of you, and just give us some information about yourself. We will send you some information about us, a letter of welcome, and some information about our different ministries, like children's ministry and adult ministries and other things. But most of all, we're glad you're here. I want to welcome you online. Those of you online, too, we're glad that you're with us. You're part of our church. I especially want to give a shout out to those of you who are in Palo Alto tonight watching us. So welcome. We're glad you're with us. Tonight we're having the service is called the Service of Lessons and Carols. We do go through a series of scripture readings and music, and then another scripture reading, and we're telling the story of the birth of Christ, so the Christmas story. So that's what we'll be doing tonight. We have a lot of students involved. If you have a child with you tonight, don't worry about them squirming and being loud. That's why we have this family service. So it's a little rowdier than usual, but that's good. We're glad for that. Let me tell you this, too. Before we begin worship, we have a tradition here at Piedmont that we take a special offering at Christmas time. And I want you to know that all the money that's collected tonight will go directly to this offering and to the organization that we're supporting. We have a video we want to show you about this organization. It's one of what we call a mission partner. We partner with them in mission here in the Oakland area. The name of the ministry is Harbor House. They minister to primarily families of immigrants in the San Antonio neighborhood of Oakland, just less than 2 miles from here, but a world apart. So watch this video. We won't take the offering now. We're going to take it later in the service. You can use this Christmas offering envelope if you'd like to use that, but all the money is going to Harbor House, so you can just put your money in unless you want a tax write-off, honestly. So you can write that on the back. If you put a cash check or cash gift in, you can write your name and address. But here's our video for our offering tonight, and welcome.
Hi, my name is Casey Stratton, and I am the executive director of Harbor House Ministries in Oakland. Harbor House is a Christian community development organization that has been around for 50 years. It's our 50th anniversary this year, and we have the pleasure of serving children and their families in the San Antonio district. So every afternoon, we walk over to Franklin Elementary School, we pick up the children, and we walk them back to Harbor House. And the first thing that they want to do is, obviously, they're very hungry, they've been at school all day, and so we have a period that's called free play and snack, and they will eat a hearty meal when they first get here, and then we give them a chance to just get out all their energy and run around and play outside. When the kids first get here in the afternoon, they have free play, and we have two main spaces for free play. We have a sport court, which is great for basketball and running around, and we have a playground. And we would expect that our younger kids would go to the playground and our older kids would stay on the sport court, but we've actually found that that's not true. A lot of our kids really want to be on the playground. And we have found that sometimes their lives can be challenging because maybe they're having to do extra responsibilities at home. And so just having a place at Harbor House where they can come and be kids.
Harbor House, after school, Harbor House is very good, you know, community center. And you know, it means a lot, not only to me, for everyone around here. We have a child, go to work, you know, and come back home lately without have a house. I think, you know, we have a lot of struggle in our life, you know, after school.
It feels like I'm so happy, like it was so fun, and they have swings, playground, outside, sport court, and everything.
That's why. I feel happy.
That's why. I love this day.
It has areas that are not safe for the kids, and so we really want to improve our playground area so that it can truly be a fun and safe place for our kids to go and have options of things that they can do in the afternoon. We are just incredibly grateful to Piedmont Community Church for allowing us to be part of your Christmas season and for choosing us for this special offering. We just hope that you know that any gift that you give will go towards providing greater spaces of safety and healing for kids in Oakland.
Please join me in the call to worship as it's printed in your bulletin. We gather this night to share good tidings of great joy. He is Christ, the Lord. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to all on whom God's favor rests.
Thank you.
may be seated. And I'd like to call up at this time one of the families of our church, Blaire and Evan Jahn, to come up and to light the Advent candle. Actually, the Christ candle tonight.
During the Advent season, we light four candles representing joy, hope, peace, joy, and love as we prepare for the coming of Christ. Tonight, we light the Christ candle in the middle to remind us that Jesus, the light of the world, was born this night in the city of David. As the prophet said, the people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given. His name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, and Prince of Peace. He is also called Emmanuel, for in him God is with us. And so we light this candle to remind us that Christ is born unto us and to the whole world on this holy night. God has made this night holy by the gift of a child born of the Holy Spirit and of Mary. Upon him rested all God's grace. Through him has come all of God's mercy. So let his light shine within our hearts right now even more brightly than it shines from the candles in this place.
Let's take a moment and go to the Heavenly Father in prayer. I invite you to join me. Father, what a fun night. To see all the faces gathered and the colors of red being shown. And God, just the excitement that we have for being here together. The anticipation of what we know we're celebrating tomorrow, the birth of your Son. So Father, I pray that you would receive glory and honor this evening. And Father, that we would experience both here and take with us tonight as we leave joy and peace and hope, and a renewed faith. So, Father, we thank you in the name of your Son, who we celebrate tomorrow. Amen.
Wish a Merry Christmas. That's right. Don't forget.
Begin our Christmas readings from Isaiah chapter 9. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests on his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. We will establish and uphold it with justice, with righteousness, from this time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of the hosts will do this.
Thank you. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph, of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary. And he came to her and said, "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great, and he will be called the Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give him the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." Then Mary said, "Here I am, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her.
Lule, my dear heart,
just written in your bulletin. In those days, a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and the family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in the bands of cloth and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the guest room. Now in the same region, there were shepherds living in fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. And the angel stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all people. To you is born this day in the city of David the Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. He will be a sign for you, and you will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth, lying in a manger." And suddenly, there was an angel in the multitude of heaven's hosts, God, and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among all those whom he favors." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and to see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child laying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told to them about the child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds had told them. And Mary treasured all these things, pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, just as it had been told.
Thank you.
Now comes the fun part. I want to invite all the kids up front. And you know what? You don't have an age limit, so if you're young at heart and want to join us, come on up. But let's come on up and have a seat on the stairs and on the floor here, okay? Well, Merry Christmas, everyone.
Thank you.
Come on in, grab a seat. You guys want to turn around a little bit so you can see me? We're just going to talk a little bit.
Hi.
Hi. So I have a question for you. If you had something that you were so excited about and that was so important and you wanted to tell somebody about it, how would you tell them? You're not sure. What do you think? How would you tell them?
I don't know. I do not even know.
You would what? You'd yell it loud?
I do not even know.
Oh, you don't even know. Well, we're going to get there. I tell you what, everything on this chair has some relation, connection to telling people about really good news. So,
that siren thing maybe is like screaming.
I'm going to get to the siren in just a minute. So, a lot of people, they have good news, they want to get news out to people, they'll put it in the newspaper, right? They'll send it to the people and then we'll all get our papers and we'll open and go, whoa, good news, right? Yep.
Can I throw the newspaper out to someone so then it's like
a
newspaper?
You sure can. Okay. There you go. But we're going to wait and do that at the end, okay? So at our church, when we have really exciting things to celebrate, we maybe will print something special. Like this, because a couple weeks ago when they lit the tree in the park, we came over and sang Christmas carols afterwards, and we wanted something printed up to give them something real good news about it. How's this look? Anybody want one of these?
Yeah,
okay, you can have that one. Everyone will get something. And then, last weekend, our choir had an amazing Christmas concert, so we made up signs. You think that would get the message across? All right, so there's all kinds of ways to get good news about really important things out, right? Anybody recognize what these are? Bells, jingle bells. Well, I'm gonna get to those in just a second. I just wanna see if you're paying attention. So I work with a lot of high school kids and sometimes they listen and sometimes they don't listen. So sometimes I have to get something big out to give good news. You think that works? All right. All right, now let's get back. Yeah, once was enough, I think. So let's get back to the jingle bells. Who, do you guys have jingle bells in your house anywhere?
I do.
Do you have them on your Christmas tree?
I don't, but I wish I would have.
Oh, so some of you had it on a hat? So let me tell you where, you know jingle bells are really from? Or why we have jingle bells at Christmas time? Because it does, because we need to hear him coming, right? So the other things that used to wear jingle bells were really big horses with sleighs, and they were coming, and sometimes you couldn't hear them because it was, and reindeer too. Thank you. I almost forgot about the reindeer. Yes, I agree. So the reindeer and the sleighs and the horses and everyone else included would have sleigh bells on them so we would know something big and important was coming because we could hear them before we could see them. All right? So, did you guys pay attention to the words that we were just reading from the Bible? God had some really exciting and important and huge news for us. And he didn't use a newspaper. And he didn't use a bullhorn. He didn't even have jingle bells or a sign, but he used angels.
Angels?
Yeah, have you guys ever seen angels? Yeah, they fly around. Have you ever seen one? Like in real life? You have?
I saw a picture of one.
Pictures of them?
I see pictures
I know. And what color are angels usually?
A blue one and a white one.
Nice. I've only seen white ones, but the blue ones, I bet, were beautiful. So God tells all of us.
I saw a purple one with a pink drapes on it.
Yes, it does look like drapes on it. But when God used an angel to tell all of us the great and wonderful joyous news that a Savior was coming and that Jesus was going to be born, the people that the angel showed up to, Mary and Joseph, and then the shepherds we just read about, their reaction to the angel was, oh, they were terrified because they'd never seen one. And I got news for you. If I saw a real angel floating up there, I'd be going, oh, too. But the angel said, don't worry. Don't be afraid. I'm bringing you good news of great joy. So what I want you guys to be ready to do tonight and tomorrow, everyone gets a jingle bell, and I want you to put it in your pocket to remind you that all of us need to do what the angels did. When we get done here tonight and go back to your families or have dinner and you get up tomorrow and celebrate Christmas, remember to jingle it to let everybody know that there's great, good news of great joy that we're celebrating, all right? So everybody grab a jingle bell and you can head back to your seat. Just one, okay? There you go. You can have that if you want. What's that? You can take a bell for them too if you want.
I'm gonna get one for my sister. I'm getting one for my mom.
Okay, that's fine. That's good too. You can take this back here too. Okay, head back here. Want a quick reminder that if you fill that Connect card, now is the time to place it in the offering that comes by, and I encourage you to give generously for part time.
Thank you. Our fourth lesson is coming from Matthew chapter 2. In the time of King Herod, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem asking, "Where is the child who has been born king of the Jews? For we observed his star at its rising and have come to pay him homage." Then Herod secretly called for the wise men and learned from them the exact time when the star had appeared. Then he sent them to Bethlehem saying, "Go and search diligently for the child, and when you have found him, bring me word so that I may also go and pay him homage." When they had heard the king, they set out, and there, ahead of them, went the star that they had seen at its rising, until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw that the star had stopped, they were overwhelmed with joy. On entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother, and they knelt down and paid him homage. Then, opening their treasure chests, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
In the beginning of the world, in the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. Through him, all things were made. Without him, the light shines in darkness, but the darkness has not understood it. There was a man who was sent from God. His name was John. He came as a witness to testify concerning the light, that light, so that through him all men might believe. He himself was not the light. He came only as a witness. He was in the world, and though the world was made through him, yet to all who received him, to those who believed in his name, he gave the right to become children of God, and the Word became flesh and dwelt among us. We have seen his glory, the glory of the one and only, who came from the Father, full of grace and truth.
Thank you for coming tonight. We hope to see you again sometime. And Scott and I would like to
wish you a Merry Christmas.
Good job, Scott. We practiced that. I forgot to mention, too, if you didn't have cash or a check tonight, you can go online to our website, piedmontchurch.org, to give to the special offering tonight. And now as you go, may the peace and the love and the joy and the hope of Christmas be with you and in you and flow through you to others. May it be so. Amen.